There's a big issue at play here as you prepare for the Trump administration. I know you're more than cognizant of the fact that Donald Trump has hundreds of millions, if not billions of dollars in businesses and business interests around the nation and throughout the world. During the campaign, he was asked what he would do with his businesses if he won. Take a listen.
If I become president, I couldn't care less about my company. It's peanuts. I have Ivanka and Eric and Don sitting there. Run the company, kids. Have a good time. I'm going to do it for America. Okay? So I would be willing to do it.
So you put your assets in a blind trust?
I would put it in a blind trust. Well, I don't know if it's a blind trust if Ivanka, Don, and Eric run it, but is that a blind trust? I don't know.
I'll answer that question. That's not a blind trust. If your kids run your businesses, it's not a blind trust. In a blind trust, there's an independent trustee who takes over your portfolio and directs it without your input or any input from anyone around you. Do you think that to avoid any conflicts of interest, not to mention questions by the public as to whether he's making decisions, at least in part for his own financial reasons, do you think it would be best for Mr. Trump to set up a true blind trust with no involvement from him or his kids?
Well, first of all, you realize that those laws don't apply to the president, right? So the president doesn't have to have a blind trust. For some reason, when the law was written, the president was exempt. I think he's in a very unusual situation. He would basically put his children out of work and they'd have to go start a whole new business, and that would set up the whole set of new problems. So it would seem to me that if he set up a situation in which the children were running it, there was a legal or clear document that meant that he would not be involved, he would have no interest in it, he would have no input into it, he would just have a passive interest. That would be the kind of thing that would work here. It's kind of unrealistic to say you're going to take the business away from the three people who are running it and give it to some independent person. And remember, they can't work in the government because of the government rule against nepotism. So you'd be putting them out of work. So I think you're going to have to fashion something that is very comfortable, something that's fair, something that assures the American people, as he said, he has no interest in what's going on in the business, and that his children get to run the business they know how to run.
Right.
And stay out of all government matters.
Well, but Mr. Mayor, I mean, his children are, you know, as I don't need to tell you, they are a huge part of his advisory committee. They are advising the transition. Ivanka, Don Jr., and Eric. Jared Kushner, Ivanka's husband, is being talked about as coming on board and working at the White House, even if he's not paid for it. If he does not set up a truly blind trust, how can the American people have confidence that when he makes a decision, that he isn't at least partly making it to enrich himself?
Well, even if he turned it over to an independent trustee and it was the Trump Corporation, you can't, I mean, there's no perfect way to do this. You have to have some confidence in the integrity of the president. The man is an enormously wealthy man. I don't think there's any real fear or suspicion that he's seeking to enrich himself by being president. If he wanted to enrich himself, he wouldn't have run for president. So I think there can be a way to do this. And by the way, Jared Kushner has his own company, completely independent of Trump, that is a very, very successful real estate company. He's maybe, you know, one of the biggest in New York. So Jared is a kind of different situation.
Well, I'll just say this, and then you can dismiss it as you want, but I'm putting a flag in it right now. If a blind trust is not set up, this is going to be an issue for Donald Trump for the duration of his presidency, because every decision he makes, whether it's the pipeline in North Dakota or business relationships in Turkey, everything is going to be under the lens of, well, what is the effect of this on his wealth and his family's wealth? I get that you think that's not a consideration or not as serious a consideration.
No. What I'm telling you is the trust solution isn't much better, meaning an independent trustee would run it, and any decision that he made, even if he didn't know it, that helped him, somebody would run it down and say, oh, my goodness, he may have made it for that reason. So blind trusts aren't perfect either. So
I think it's far better than
the situation.
It's far better than people in his family advising him and then also working on his business.
Once he gets into government, they will not be advising him. There'll have to be a wall between them with regard to government matters. And something I'm very familiar with from my days in the Justice Department, which is recusing yourself from decisions that involve you or any financial matter involving you.
All right. Well, if you thought the issues between the Clinton Foundation and Hillary Clinton State Department were big, fasten your seatbelts. But let's move on. Mr. Trump shook up the Republican primary.
I think, Jake, I think that's a very unfair suggestion. There you were talking about enormous amounts of cash. I'm counting up to about $230 million that went for specific actions like talking to the IRS, and I don't see that happening in a Trump administration. This man didn't run for president because he wants to get rich. He's rich already, so
all right.
I don't think you're going to have that happen unless you try to make it happen.
All right.